All right, so this video is going to be a video on how I cleaned out a really bad ear infection I had last year. I've had so many different health issues and medication and antibiotics that was given to me by ER doctors and my regular PCP doctor did not help. So I had to, by the grace of God, do things on my own, and God gave me wisdom how I can go about doing it. Obviously, a demon would not give me insight of how I can clean out a ear infection. So all of my wisdom comes from God. Whatever I'm supposed to do, whatever I do, is by God's mercy and His wisdom. Because obviously, demons do not enjoy people being healthy or being able to cure themselves. They like to mock you, they like to ridicule you, and they like to see you suffer. So I refuse it, and by the power of the precious blood of Jesus, I am able to do things God's way. So these are some of the ingredients, well, things that you would need to purchase if you want to clean your ears out naturally. So basically, on the side, before I do that, I just wanted to share that if you're allergic to fluoride, which I know I am, you can add a couple of cinnamon drops into the Listerine mouthwash and just dip your toothbrush in some of this solution and brush your teeth and your gums with it, because cinnamon oil is really good to kill bacteria. I actually also have gum issues, and I had a really two really bad root canal infections in my gums, and this killed the bacteria in my gums. I highly recommend this. I mean, even veterinarians say that you can give these to dogs. Like, I mean, if we take care of more of our animals than we do our own health, that's not good. So take care of your health. Okay, so and I actually use this also to spray my dogs, my dog and my pets for fleas. I dilute it in water, and I brush it on their coat, and it helps. It smells good, and it helps kill bugs. Anyway, so all right, so let's get to it. So if you want to get rid of a really bad ear infection, I went to an ENT. They just checked my nose, and he knew I had a really bad virus going on, and he's like, "Here, just take a couple of ear drops and this nasal spray, and it should clear out." And I actually even asked him, "Well, can you? It's hurting me really bad. Can you probably order a CT scan to check to see if it might be something serious?" He said, "No, you're too young. I don't want to put you at risk of any radiation." So dumb. I am young, but it's okay. I actually want to know what's going on with me. Like, I can understand if I'm old and, I'm at risk of dying, but I'm young. I can handle radiation. Like, I need to know what was the problem. And he didn't, so I did not go to him. And I actually, my ear got worse, and I was in the ER, and I usually don't take medication. I'm against antibiotics now because I am immune to them. Like, my body's antibiotic resistant, so I can't even, it won't even kill any bug that I have in my system. That's how bad my immune system is to antibiotics. So I went to the ER, and I needed ibuprofen because that's the one medicine that I do take for pain, and I was in extreme pain. My inner ear was hurting. It was just painful. I actually had pus and mucus inside of my inner ear, my left ear, and the ER doctor gave me 800 milligrams of ibuprofen to take, and also some ear drops, which did not work. I don't know what was in that ear drops. Looked like a milky thing, junk. No idea what was in it, and it did not work. I put it in my ears for a week, and it did not work. So anyway, sorry to talk a lot about my health issues, but I just want to make this video for whoever's suffering from an ear infection. Okay, so after that, God gave me the wisdom of doing things on my own, and so he told me that the ears, nose, and throat is connected, right? So you have to do a nasal drip cleanse after showering. And so what you would do is you would you would pour some filtered water. This is not alkaline. I just use refill the bottle with regular purified water. So you use a filtered purified water, and then you put it like about this much, and then you can put, I don't have that with me right now, lemongrass oil. Okay, these are essential oils. You get the lemongrass oil and you put 1 to 2 drops of the lemongrass oil in here, essential oils. And then I also saw in another YouTube video by another guy, really smart, thank you. He got colloidal silver, a bottle, and he poured some of the colloidal silver solution in here. So it's lemon, two, 1 to 2 drops of lemongrass oil, colloidal silver, okay, and filtered water. So what you do is you would like, squeeze. This is a syringe I have. You would squeeze in all of the water solution, and you would obviously, I'm not going to show you. Spray it up your nose in one nose, and then tilt your head, and it would come out in the other nostril. So you have to take care of your nose, like to take care of your ears together. Like it goes together, ears, nose, and throat. So and it might sting, but you have to clean out your nasal cavity. So you just do that maybe every other day after showering, and after you do that, then you would get a Q-tip, okay, and then the excess that you have of the solution, you can actually still use it, and you get a Q-tip, right, and then you put it, and then clean your ears out, okay. That is really good way to clean out the bacteria in your ears, because it's a really bad infection that you have in the ears. And I did that, and then at night, I bought this from Amazon. This is a really good product. It's called Pro Ear, okay. And the ingredients are really awesome in here. It has sesame oil, capric, I can't even say it. Something caprylic oil that's in coconut oil, jojoba oil, aloe vera. Oh, my camera's going stupid again. Sorry. Anyways, this has really good stuff in it that's natural, and I actually opened this up, like literally, not just unscrewed it. Let me see if I could do this here. So I popped up this out, okay, and I heard garlic is a really good antibacterial and anti-inflammatory. So I put like probably like a couple drops of the garlic in it. Okay, after I pop that out. And this is a really good product also. This is oregano oil capsules. Okay, so this one I also did, and it looks like that. It's a white pill, and it smells really strong, like oil of oregano. Like this is the oil. Like this is really good stuff. So what I did was I got a flat board or cutting board, and I placed it on the cutting board, and then I got one of these, and I bang 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 bang, and kind of like people do that, sorry to compare, but that do cocaine, and they get the dust and that and they do whatever, God forgive them. But anyway, so after you get the dust from the oil of oregano pill, you would put it inside this along with the garlic oil, okay, and you would obviously close it up, shake it up, shake it up, shake it up, and then you can either directly put this in your eardrops, like 1 or 2 or 3 drops at night at bedtime. Or if you feel like you're scared or whatever, you can actually, put it on a Q-tip at night, and then just clean out your ears again. This you should do at least every day at night. I did this for 1 week, My ears still were itching and they kind of hurt. So I went back to urgent care. I did not go to ER this time. I went to urgent care. And the urgent care doctor that was there that day, I said, "Hey, you know what? I think I have an ear infection. Can you check my ears? Because I want to see if this worked or not." He did. And he checked my left ear first. He said, "I don't see any ear infection. It looks pretty clean." And then I said, I asked him to check the right ear, my right ear, and he said, "Yeah, it's clean also." So it worked. So God helped me clean out my ears from my ear infection naturally. And I hope this helped anyone who's going through a really bad ear infection. I know it's really painful. Like I said, I don't take medication. I just take ibuprofen if I'm in extreme pain, and or anti-diarrhea medication or anti-nausea medication for extreme cases. I hope you had a good day, and I hope this benefited someone. Thank you. Have a blessed day. Bye.